to Creature Corner. My name is Jared Krichevsky. This is the place for creatures. And if you like corners, we have a corner for you where we can sit and talk about creatures. It's very complex. Anyway, we are very blessed and happy to have back with us our friend, the survivor, Matt Millard.
Get over here!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
I like that.
Yes. Hello, sir. Welcome back, man. So you obviously, like, if you watched last week's harrowing episode, we were all wondering if Matt was going to make it.
Yeah.
We were all
Superman.
Yeah.
It's been honestly a really hectic, like, couple of weeks, man.
Yeah.
Like, didn't have power for like 4 or 5 days almost. Everything's destroyed, you know, can't work, can't do anything.
My God.
Except for sit outside.
You could say, yeah, in the blackness.
In the complete.
And you got the chance to contemplate the void.
Yeah, it was great, honestly. Like, having a couple of days where, like, nothing works.
Yeah.
You're just, like, I'm just gonna sit outside and have a couple of beers and fall down.
Fall down.
I'm just joking.
You're just tripping. You're just tripping. And then last weekend was Easter. Oh, well, yeah, if you're not caught up, Matt is, there was a tragic tornado that swept through Arkansas. Yeah, a little crazy. And so Matt got narrowly missed.
I mean, nothing's feet, hundreds of feet away, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
A few streets down, they're still, it's nuts.
Yeah, so, yeah, so, Matt, I'm just happy to have you back.
I'm just ready to party.
Happy you made it. I hope this weekend, this Easter weekend, was nice for everybody. Yeah. So, anyway, let's get to the creatures and let's catch up where we were last week. And, I got to take
a course. And here we are.
There we go. Bam. Right? Let's bring him over. So this is where I left off with Zeddy last time.
Oh, yeah. You got the Power Ranger head blocked in.
Yeah, we got that blocked in. The vein work is kind of also blocked in as well. One thing Matt and I have continuously talked about is getting that, like, fibrous kind of layer on top of it. And so that's kind of my plan today, is just to generate that surface level stuff, you know, add that tertiary detail in there, polish up any of the kind of remaining details. I want to kind of tech this out a little bit, any polishing on the head. The staff, I think the staff is going to just take me, like, just a couple dedicated hours where I just need to sit down and just, like, work this thing out and think about it. And then blocking out the base here, we got the Power Ranger head. And then I need some more dynamic rocks, right? Because you gotta have, like, spiky alien, like, dynamic rocks.
Yeah, it's a must. It's a go-to and a must.
And the question is that bone or metal? The answer is yes. Bone. It's like a this is Lord Zed, you know, Zeddy, as I like to call him.
Oh, like, I didn't have the chat turned on. Hello, everyone.
yeah. So I'm off on a Power Rangers villain. Getting pretty close, though.
Yeah, it's looking great.
Close is there. It's just, like, final details, that push pass that we like to say. And then, you know, depending. I mean, you can always go on this forever. But depending on how much time, I can start maybe blocking in a a ranger. Poor Billy.
Yeah. Dang.
You know, something like that. He's absolutely just crushing the Rangers.
Yeah.
All hope is lost. Zed is like the fiercest, you know, fighter.
I like it.
Yep, and that's the plan today. Matt, what about you?
Slowly chipping away on this guy, the Burke.
The Burke.
Dr. Birkin, Smirkin' Birkin from Resident Evil 2.
Slowly chipping away.
I made this change. I think I'm basically like out of design land, and then I've just got to finish everything now. The last big change I did was I moved these flaps of skin over the face here. They were sitting like in the middle of the teeth, and it looks cool, but it was just obscuring that that secondary jaw that I like so much that I put in there, and the light actually falls a lot better off of it too.
Yeah, that's cool.
In render, I've been looking at it in gray just to see like how it's going to read after we print it out, you know. You can just really start to see, you know, you take all the paint away and all the textures away, you can start to see where the forms, like where things need to go. Like, you know, I need to render out this entire arm, but all the forms are there. Need to render out this entire arm. Forms are almost there. And these damn mushy legs. And I think that'll be solid.
It's looking great, dude. And that's always a good reminder is doing a gray pass. You know, just check the forms, check the read. You can read, if it looks good in grayscale, it's going to look good when you put those techies on it.
Oh, you got to hit them with them techies. A lot of people don't know that that's an industry.
Techies.
It's a technical techie.
Welcome, Donkey Show. Yes, we are here to make some monsters for you today. Just going to work the base a little bit, maybe shrink some of this. Yeah, man. Did you see Super Mario yet?
No, I have not.
I have not seen it yet.
Oh, what are we hearing about it?
I mean, it made a lot of money this weekend.
Oh, you know what? That's right. I did read that. That it did really,
it did really,
really well.
Getting somewhat salted, I don't know. Like people, you know, slamming it a little bit. I don't know.
Because Chris Pratt doesn't.
I'm assuming that's a big part of it. I don't know. I haven't seen the movie. But if
has anyone,
if my instinct says anything, it's probably fine and it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I mean, I guess some of the response I've seen on the internet has been, "Oh, I love the movie. I don't know why people."
Yeah,
hate
that's
it.
Usually the. You know, the like pre-hype, like, it's good, you know, the pre-hype trash. I guess.
But dude, like, nerds hate
everything.
Yeah, I know,
everything.
Dude. So it's just like...
You're just like tired at this point. Like, okay, man, you didn't like it. Cool, whatever. Some of us liked it.
Some of us like things.
Yeah, usually there's something that like precedes a lot of hate and people are trash on. Then you watch it and you're like, no, it's fine. What are you talking about? It's a very kid movie-ish. Yeah, oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's like big. It's Nintendo.
Mario, yeah. And Nintendo's trying to make, you know, $500 million.
Yeah.
And I think they knew what they were doing. You go to the Minions people, because Minions made so much money. money.
Yeah.
I mean, you look at it and like, as a CG artist, it looks gorgeous, right? Story aside, yeah. Chris Pratt aside, like it, the art direction on that is beautiful. And I think that look is very appealing, especially for young children who like bright colors, and, you know, looks awesome. See, when I grew up, our Super Mario Brothers were those two like dudes in the garage. It really looked nothing like Mario.
Mm-hmm.
The brothers. But I had those on VHS. Yes, I'm dating myself.
I miss VHS.
I do too.
But only for nostalgic reasons. It's just like, I mean, it's a terrible format. Compared to... It was funny though, like everything required like some sort of manual... You always had to do some sort of manual thing.
Yes.
You know, like you had to rewind it, or, you know, you got to open up this crazy machine. I remember whenever I was a kid and the VCR broke, it's like, oh, this is never getting fixed. This is like space technology, dude. Like nobody knows how to fix these things. This is ridiculous, you know? You always had to do some sort of crazy.
You had to like
put on the cartridge, take the tape, or whatever.
You had to hold it all down and then jiggle the cartridge, and then, you know, slam all the buttons on the controller for it to work. And then...
And now it's just like, you just buy the games online and they just download onto your system pretty well. Same thing with movies and TV.
It's all just one unit feeding into our brain. What is that?
One unit. Into
our brains.
Ah, fingernail. What are you doing, fingernail?
That would be very dumb.
Yeah, I think I'll...
Yeah, it seems like it was probably fine. Yeah, and generally, if you like bad movies, you're going to be okay with most things. I love bad movies. I love absolutely terrible movies.
Get that smooth, stronger. Always. Not always. Oh, dude, I get to see an early screening of Renfield tomorrow.
Oh, no
way. Yeah.
That's already coming out, isn't it?
Yeah, dude. That's crazy.
I mean, it doesn't seem like that long ago.
It looks great. I can't wait.
It does look great. I think, really, we just have to see it now at this point.
Mm-hmm. Hoping for that credit. What we want.
That's what we're hoping for. Hoping for a baby.
Just a weird mutated arm. No reference. It's just like, I'm just gonna make it. I'm gonna split all these muscles up. Make them wiggle around. Do a little jib jab.
A little jib jab.
Sometimes you gotta jab them down. Didn't like that. Yeah, Yeah, so what's next on the list, man? What are we thinking?
What for movies, or what are we talking? What are we talking?
For next week.
Well, that's a good question. Because we were talking about doing something kind of wacky, like Rat Fink.
Yeah, like some sort of weird Rat Fink horror.
If you guys don't know what Rat Fink is, it's like this style, yeah. Right? And we haven't really done anything. We did Janky Mups, and you know, we do a lot of silly things, but we've been wanting to do something in this Ring Fink. I'm gonna learn to spell one day.
I cannot.
But kind of like, I love the pushed eyes out of the socket, and the rows of teeth, the smile that goes up really big. This could be a really, really fun kind of thing to run with. And so maybe that's what we guys can get from you, is maybe you want to throw out an animal and we'll do it, and we'll like Frankenstein monster it. What do you think?
Yeah.
We'll Frankenstein monster. Yeah, big teeth, eyes, bulging. And if nobody tells me, I'm just going to do a full-size duck.
A full size.
Yeah, Rob Zombie also. He's invited to America. Like, I love this guy right here. Yeah. Look at this one. Yeah
dude. Like, I've got that one.
Like, this piece is right on the market.
Mm-hmm.
And that would be a ton of fun to paint. Big rows of teeth. I love that the, see, like, the orbital or the, the optic nerve, and then the drool, all this stuff. Like, so that's kind of the goal for next week, because we're gonna wrap up this week wherever we end it. We're just gonna wrap up and move on.
Moving on.
Because I think, you know, we're both getting to the finesse stage where we just need to sit and kind of like do that last bit.
That last Marlon.
That last little Brando. Guy's gone full Brando. You know what? Like right now, I'm trying to figure out if I lost last week's work or not.
What do you mean?
Oh, I saved out a different file. See, I versioned up. I did my homework and I versioned up. There we go. I just opened the wrong file.
You were working.
Yeah, I was like, wait a minute.
Okay.
I've already done this part. And start cleaning up the file a little bit.
I'm just dinking on some monster hands here.
Dinking.
Yeah, just dinking around, man. Dinking on them monster hands.
Good friend dinking. Yeah, I was totally looking at the wrong file. That's pretty great.
Okay. How different is it?
Much. I mean, you can see, like, I was going to the butt. I was like, wait a minute. All right.
Oh, sweet. I like our creepy music.
Lo-fi creepy tunes to kill you. Rat Fink, Frankenstein, yes. Definitely, if we do Rat Fink, Frankenstein, any of the classic monsters.
Yeah, we should Rat Fink, Rat Fink's Monsters.
Rat Fink's Monsters, The Mummy would be fun.
It's also one of those things, like the props, whenever we start thinking about them too far ahead of time, we start to obsess and come up with a million ideas.
We psych ourselves out.
Yeah.
Willie's currently watching the old Ghostbusters, the animated series. I was just talking about that with somebody.
Nice. Yeah, I remember they had the game on Nintendo too.
Did you ever get like
on the old game?
Because I never got all the gear, but I had a friend who had the packs and the traps. The packs and the traps.
Cut that out right there.
I don't think I ever played the game.
Oh, like the OG one?
The OG one.
It was so funny, like how much of your imagination you would have to use back then playing those games, you know, like... You see the cover and it's some sick ass art, you know, like Mutant League Football or whatever.
And then you get
in the game on like the original like Nintendo and it's just little pixels and you're like, oh, that's a person.
You're like, oh,
I'm jumping, you know.
So much of it, yeah, was
like your brain's just putting things together, you know.
Or it's just a bummer when you saw that art. And it just didn't match in the game.
Oh, yeah. But, I mean, they peeled that Band-Aid off at, I mean, like, way early. Right?
Yeah.
It was like, I mean, even today that still happens when it's like, oh, preview footage of this new game, and then it comes out and looks way different. You know?
Yeah, everybody, it's just a cutscene. It's a pre-rendered cutscene.
Mm-hmm.
Actual game footage.
Actual Marmaduke Marmalade.
Matt, are you playing any games right now?
I am playing the Resident Evil 4 remake.
Okay.
Yeah,
and you're loving it. I only hear great things.
Oh, yeah. It's very good. I don't have time to play it.
No. We don't have time for play.
I played a little bit over the weekend on Easter. I'm getting pretty far. Put some time in. But man, yeah, it's great. I'm playing it on hardcore.
Which is really, really hard.
Yeah, it's a good time. But man, they bait you into it. Because at the beginning of the game, it's like, what difficulty do you want to play on? And it's like, standard, easy, and hard, and then, or hardcore. And on hardcore, the description is, if you've played Resident Evil 4 before, you should play on, like, you have to play on this.
Okay.
And it's like, oh man, all right, well.
Oh, sweet, okay.
I can't pick normal, because it literally says, if you've never played Resident Evil 4, you should pick the normal. And I was like, oh, come on. Dude, I can't do that. Gotta stay true. It's great. Having a blast.
Yeah, I'm still Still poking around Elden Ring.
Dude, nice. What a wonderful game.
Still there, still going slow. But I'm thinking of picking up RE4 just so I have a break in the Elden Ring.
Yeah. Don't forget to save your work.
Great idea.
Save your work.
Combo breaker.
Combo
breaker. Ready to go. Anyway, what are you guys working on? You guys making monsters out there?
Yeah, what's the deal? What are y'all doing?
Deal.
See any good movies?
See any good movies? Play a good game. We're all just making monsters here.
That's what we do. Combo breaker.
So cool.
Combo. Man, I loved me some Killer Instinct back in the day.
Oh, man, those graphics at the time were a big deal.
Dude, seeing Fulgor and, like, Glacius, like, do their moves and stuff, you're like, dude, these guys are sick. Spinal.
Spinal, dude. The Harryhausen skeleton, I mean.
Yeah.
Loved Spinal.
The Wolfman. The Raptor.
I mean, they just hit all the great, like, archetypes. Jade. Really awesome. okay.
Jago. TJ Combo.
TJ Combo. Yeah, you got the boxer dude.
Supreme yeah.
Victory. Yes.
Yeah, Supreme Victory.
Taking that mask by noise feature.
Yeah.
And then just doing that little trick, and I'm just going to paint out some holes here.
He's going to paint some holes.
We're going to paint some holes. Okay, so masking, turning my focal shift all the way down. And paint some holes. And in this case, instead of extracting, I just duplicated the geometry, and I'm just gonna polygroup this and delete hit.
Yeah, the quick.
Because I could extract it, or I could just do that.
Yeah. I like me a good old quick and dirty every now and then.
Yeah, you know. Doesn't take much. is definitely one of the most fun little tricks to do. I love this trick. It's a little trickity trick.
It's got moves.
We got some moves. We got some moves coming up. It's like the fascia. The fascia.
The fascia.
It's the fascia. Who's your fascia?
There we go. I like that.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
Okay, so group that together. That leaves us with holes. Lots of holes.
He's got holes.
Gonna delete hidden. And then after that, I want to find any kind of loose groups. Auto group it. Select. And then delete any hidden. So there's no little surprises in there. And I take this guy and group loop it. Now this is going to take a little bit if I don't crash it immediately.
Oh no.
Did you save?
No, I did not.
Oh God.
What? Oh no.
I lived dangerously, but guess what? It did it. And I love how James is just ready. So there you go. That's what it looks like. I'm going to fill it with like a yellow issue just so I can see it. Ah, too yellow.
But I tell you what, that is some ugly mustard.
Okay, there we go. Anyway, there we go. Okay, so now it's sitting on the surface. And I can basically just preview dynamic.
Preview dynamic.
So that's like sitting on the surface. And right now it's like too much. So I'm going to polish it. Do that a few times. Also, because it's one-sided geometry, I can also use Sculptress to kind of eat away at some of this.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Because right now it's cool, but there's, you know, it's all over the place, so. I can kind of eat away at it with Sculptress to smooth it away.
Might be interesting to try and do some cloth stuff with it too.
Oh, that might be cool. Bet your cloth, yeah, cloth would, let's try it. I think I want to be able to turn everything off at will. So we'll just call it armor.
Whoopies!
Whoopie!
Whoopie!
Whoops!
Yeah, you know what? No one cares. No one cares about this anymore.
Whoops.
Okay, fuck that.
Oh, that's his visor. Okay, gotcha.
Man, I think I'm ready to... You know what? I do want to mess up this eyeball a little bit. Maybe, like, make that a little unique comparatively to the traditional designs. I don't know how. Maybe I'll just kind of, like, wiggle it around and make it a little... Like, it's kind of screwed up somehow. What it really means is...
The other thing is this geometry is like super heavy, so I have to decimate it.
Oh, you can, or yeah, you could like isolate pieces of it, you know?
Oh, that's true.
That's, yeah, that's the trick that I do is like I'll just, you can just like isolate the arm.
Yeah. Smart. Decimation Master. What a great, like, finishing move.
Finish him.
Finish him. Willie says he's focusing on storyboarding, working on a freelance project before I start building.
Nice.
Yeah, storyboarding as a portfolio thing is so hard. It's really hard. Giving yourself a story to work with, you know? Great exercise. Keep at it, man. Keep at it. Keep running. Okay, question from Easy Mode. When sculpting from a front side photo, do you gather more references for the like side or you can't see, or do you just input your own idea? Okay, so gather as much reference as you can. And if there is not enough reference, then you can just make it up. I think just like inference, you know, just reference as best as you can. And there's always going to be interpretation because it's your, you know, it's your hand touching it. You know, if it was me or Matt, we might have a different style. If it was another artist, that person might have another style. We're all going to put our like individual spin on things. The only true representation is really a scan, right? Just absolute scanning the thing, the person. I love that eye, Matt. That looks awesome.
Let's check it out. Pop it out a little bit. Hold on.
Make a file for just references. Absolutely. I have tons and tons of references. Lots of reference folders. Party Town.
Believe in Party Town.
Believe in Party Town.
For it believes in you.
Big eyeballs in my shoulder.
Yeah, because am I mistaken, or is it not in the Resident Evil 2 in the cover? When was that? 98? Okay, let's check. Now there's a cutscene. Where's the eyeball cutscene? I can swear. It's my life's work. Don't you do it. Can't find it. Yeah, maybe some more veins. I might start disfiguring it a little bit. I actually forgot that I made that brush. What was it called?
Did you have like a vein brush?
No, it was a the like flesh tear brush.
Oh yeah. You were using that in the beginning.
Skin Murder is what it is called. Yeah, I mean, look at that. That's great. Let's just go ahead. Whatever. Grab this. Any chisel. There we go. Let's just see. Yeah, like having it like tear off like that. What do you think about something like that, dude? Having it kind of like...
Oh, yeah, that's cool. It looks like it's interacting more.
Like it...
You know, with the body around it.
Yeah, and it's like the threads of the iris, you know, are pouring into the eyeball. The threads of the iris.
Threads of the iris. Damn. Brought to you by...
The brush is pretty gnarly. Let's see what else we got. Okay. Oh yeah. The back piece. Oh, that's a good one.
So actually, in lieu of using Decimation Master, I tried Tessimate over here. Uh-huh. And I just did it like that. Just a great way of like breaking it down. So this was my geometry after I duplicated it. I was like, man, this is taking forever if I try to decimate and pre-process. So I came over here to Tessimate, hit Tessimate, and then that's it. Like, it just lowers the... Let me clear the mask. There we go. And it lowers the geometry.
Oh, look at that.
Really fast.
Well, that's cool.
And then, really, I was just kind of dialing it up and down. And it really doesn't lose too much shape.
Yeah, man.
It kind of caches it a little bit. But, and it's added some kind of edge to it, which makes it even kind of cooler.
Yeah, that's tight.
It's tight.
It's tight.
Tight. I'm learning.
I'm learning.
I'm learning. Now just eroding it away and kind of like chewing away some of the thickness because I don't want the muscle fibers to get lost underneath this. More auto group. Just one more.
One more.
Come on, man. I just need one more auto group.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Is there a bee in the room?
More like a bee. Thank you.
Eyeballs in my shoulder.
Just like Mom used to make.
Just like Mom used to make. The nuclear family is back. Eyeballs for dinner.
Martha, why doesn't this come up?
My eyeballs are wet. Didn't you dry them out?
I don't want these eyeballs. Well, you're getting them anyway.
Well, Jimmy, eat your damn...
Just eat the eyeballs, Jimmy.
Eat the eyes, kid.
You can't talk to me that way.
Let's take a meandering gandering, Your Honor. No. What I want is that to be filled with the color black. Now I can stop worrying. Aha, just kidding. What? What's your favorite color? It's pissing me off. Get in there. Almost. Painful. It's painful being dumb sometimes.
Being dumb?
Yeah.
It does hurt.
Hurts being dumb.
Hurts real bad. Look, man, we got smooth brains. There's nothing we can do. Am I wasting my time?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I got my my other printer. I'm printing a test on it right now of this guy, actually, all one piece, just to see if it'll print out of box. I didn't even like test it or level it or anything. I was like, whatever.
We haven't checked in a while, but how long have you guys been doing these live sessions from Carlos? Man, we've been doing this over a year.
Yeah.
And actually, I mean, heck, why not? We decided this year we were going to do something a little crazy, a little out there.
I know how to get there.
We know how to get there, but like getting there has been a journey. Anyway, we're on the road to Monster Palooza.
Yeah. There you go.
There it is. So we're going to Monster Palooza this year, first weekend in June, Pasadena Convention Center, Monster Palooza, booth 449.
449.
Next to the concession stand. And, you can actually come meet us. This is us. We're in the hunchback section.
Oh, nice.
So come hang out with us, get a hot dog or get some popcorn. But we're going to have some things for sale.
Just the diabetes.
mostly ourselves. We will be for sale. You can purchase Matt or I at a discount price.
Of two hot dogs and a Bud Light.
That's really, we're very cheap dates.
Yeah.
It's going to be a lot of fun. And man, Matt's been printing. You just got, you said you got your baby printer going.
Yeah. Baby. Yeah.
Your baby printer. My big boy is down.
It's about
never got up.
Yeah, so you replaced the sensor and everything, and
it's first still... test went great. Like, I did the roof test, and it went great. I was like, oh sweet, we're in business. And next time I try, and I printed my pumpkin face boy.
Yeah.
And
yeah, they turned out great.
Oh dude, and they look fantastic.
Yeah.
And it failed on my big boy, and I was like, okay.
Oh no.
Yeah. I was like, what? And so I'm like, okay, just up the exposure, boom, we're back in business, right? Okay. And then that next print, it starts doing the thing again. Like it
just
Yeah, where it's crashing into the LCD.
Dude, what?
It goes like, you know, and I'm like,
it what?
It goes, and so I have to shut it off, and it's like completely unusable.
Well, I mean, did you hit up Krusty Service?
I did. I'm, I reached out to him. I've not heard back. So I don't know, man. I just got a big boy there that I bought that's just kind of sitting there not working. I got my boy back. My plus is working, and then I have my mono, my little dude.
Yeah,
my little dude's cranking away. He's doing some prints. Let's see what I got for him.
Well, that's great.
So I can keep going.
Yeah, I mean we're gonna have to.
We're gonna have to keep going. But Pumpkin Face Boy turned out pretty fun. Look at that guy.
Yeah, he looks great, dude.
Isn't he great? Yeah. It's hard to see on this camera, but all the details are there. His little candles, and I plused up the sculpt too. You know, nice. I spent some good time on that. So he's got little pumpkin seeds in there now. So that's also a part of it. And plused up the teeth, and it's
the thing is just so. Oh, there it is. It's in focus. Yeah, look at that, dude. That's kick ass.
Yeah, man. And this that one I forgot drainage holes, but I fixed that, and I'm printing the next batch.
Well, I mean, did it print fine without drainage holes?
It did.
Yeah.
But I mean, ultimately, it's not good because you have uncured resin. In right. there, and with enough heat, it could expand and explode.
And we like explosions, but we don't want people to get hurt by our prints.
No, this was my elf girl who I also plussed up this one. Her ear,
Ear
broke.
Yeah,
so that's also the case. But I'm, you know, I also spent some time kind of tightening up the model too.
Awesome, dude. yeah, it looks good.
And rebalancing it because, you know, you print these things large and then it tips over and you're like, ah, crap.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, so that's the part of like rapid prototyping, like seeing it physically changes kind of like how you will sculpt digitally as well.
Exactly.
You know, and the cool thing part about this is like, oh, I can make a change and do it again. Like the ears are always a little delicate and they've been snapping off, you know, just you barely bump into it, you move it, you ding something, the ears snap off and you're like, yeah, crap. So I'm going to go back and plus up the ears a little bit, thicken them up.
Yeah.
You know, add a little like texture and bark to them. So the thickening makes sense. Krichevsky collectibles. Yes. I like that. So, working on these two little bitties right now, and hoping to get a bunch of those.
Love Pumpkin Guy.
Pumpkin Guy is a Jambo, man.
He's love me a full Jambo.
Love me a full Jambo.
Ooh.
I
think
we're getting all day Monday painting, and it was like the best day.
Hell yeah.
You know, like no computer, just like music on.
Yeah.
Paint.
Heck yes.
I'm talking.
It's addictive.
Oh, dude, it's the greatest thing ever. So fun. I can't wait to get back into it. Been in a slump for a little while, but
I
fixed that or got that printer at least, the new one at least, set up. Man, I've got to tell you though, like I engineered a print. I auto supported a print like quickly of this guy on like the build volume for this is the Phenom, just the regular Phenom.
Right.
Regular Phenom. I have the large, and whenever I sliced it on the Phenom settings, it said it was going to be like 35 hours or something.
Okay.
And I was like, what? The
same kind of thing that happened to me too, where I was like, what is the time?
Yeah, well, I guess I just didn't realize like how much faster the L was, man. Like, because if I was to print it on the L, it'd be done, you know, probably 20 hours.
Really?
Yeah.
And you might have sold me on the L because my Max isn't doing nothing.
It's a shame.
It is a damn shame. I'm very sad. I'm a sad, sad man.
Dude, look at this eyeball, Jared.
That was before the thing. What?
Look at my eyeball.
Dude, that's a great eyeball.
It's looking like mutated, right?
Do you want to? I think you should like curve tube snap some veins on top.
Oh, yeah. Kind of like trace some of the veinage on there.
Yeah. Like some big blues.
Some big blues?
Big blues. Maybe over the arm, but like the eye definitely needs some veinage.
Okay. I'm ready.
We're ready to go to Vein Town. Okay. We're on the road.
To Marvin Palooza.
It's some kind of road. But we were actually just talking about it today. T-shirts and stickers. Fallen King. Fallen King, you are an angel. Thank you so much.
Hell yeah.
I love you. You specifically. We're having a good time. Well, if you have 3D prints for sale at Monsterpalooza, we're hoping so.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Like,
it's looking like, you know, we'll have what we have.
Yeah.
You know?
What kind of print would you want?
Yeah, which, is there like one?
Is there like a price range or a size? Like, that's what we're trying to figure out.
Yeah, I mean, and we have
like, you know, would you buy a pumpkin man? Pumpkin man's
trying to offer like different ranges of them. Indy wants all of them.
Oh yeah,
I love it. Yeah, we're just like right now. I'm just trying to generate them. Next year we will definitely we're gonna try and go casting. That way we can get a lot more of them. You buy a pumpkin man, get our pumpkin mans. I mean, it's exciting.
A little bit of a road.
It's like some kind of journey that we're on. But I tell you, nothing like a deadline and some intense pressure. Creepy Moon Boy. Yeah, I have to finish the sculpt. Because we did one episode on Creepy Moon Boy, and that was it.
Yeah, dude, yours turned out so sick.
But I looked at it again. This is where he's... Where is he?
I must be missing... Oh, it's going down. I have missed every piece of chat. Sorry, guys.
See, I'm thinking of, so this is where I left him.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, dude, you could just like have his creepy head and his little hands popping over on a cloud. Look at that.
This is where this is where I left him, so I haven't really touched him.
That's great. This. Yeah.
I mean, maybe if I took it to a bust.
Yeah.
Yes.
What if, okay, hear me out. I put his hands like this.
Oh, yeah, dude.
No, what if his
hands, yeah.
And he's kind of like this.
Mm-hmm, I love that.
So he's like, he's just creeping.
He is, that is creepy.
Shut up and take my money.
I like it.
So, yeah, I think, I have so many projects and so much stuff to do. So I just don't know if I'm going to make Creepy Moon Boy on time. But hear me out. I was thinking of doing a sticker or B, a graphic t-shirt.
Dude, it'd be a perfect.
Yeah, because I can do the poster.
Sticker, like, look at that. Yeah.
Yeah. And it works really well graphically. Like, that's Creepy Moon Boy right now. Grab his little body. I can turn his body off. There you go. That's like Creepy Moon Boy.
Yes.
Yes.
Would you buy a Creepy Moon Boy t-shirt?
Me?
Yeah, would you?
Yeah, dude.
That's the question.
I would, if it was creepy enough, I would buy it.
If it was a Creepy Moon Boy. Misty, what's up?
What up?
What's up, Misty? Thanks for coming and hanging out with us. Creepy Moon Boy. Okay, I'm just going to do some clock on this. Which is the whole point of this thing.
All right. It's almost detail time, I think. Let's see here. This thing's gonna be a nightmare print.
Oh, killed it. I was doing it and then I killed it.
How to die.
In clot sim.
Mm.
And it was looking perfect.
Well, that's how it usually goes. I'm sorry, bud.
I will survive.
There we go.
Yeah, man, that claw sim did it. Diddy done did it, buddy.
What do you mean? Like it killed it?
No, like it looks sweet now.
Oh, okay, cool. What's up? Let's see it. Make it grow! Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, claw sim fucking worked out great. That's awesome.
Yeah, that looks great. Looks very organic. That nice kind of veiny textural breakup that we were talking about.
Yeah, man.
Sometimes it works out.
I use it for so many things. Right. Let's split these guys off. I'll probably do cloth sim on this too.
Should. Everyone should do a little cloth sim.
Everyone should do a little bit of cloth sim.
Put a little bit of cloth sim into your love. No, I didn't lose too much. It's okay. Yeah, the veins look good. That's yes.
Varnal Marmons.
Indy Respawn is asking, Matt, did you work on the new D&D movie?
I did not. But you know who did?
Who's that?
You did.
Yes, I did work on it. I worked on it. I worked on it. I did. No, I got to do some stuff with Legacy Effects. Very awesome stuff. And some of it got cut. But that's okay. Them's the breaks sometimes. Yeah, man. It was still fun to work on. And I saw my friend Luca Nemolato had posted. His like little chubby dragon, which was awesome.
God, dude. The level of execution, that's insane.
Oh, dude, Luca's always been like so good. Well, we got to get him on here.
I'm into it.
Yeah, it's he's always been really, really good. But very fun movie. You saw it. I haven't gotten to see it yet.
Oh, yeah. It was great.
Yeah, and generally getting, like, really great reviews. And
I think it did really well.
All right. Let's send it over.
Disgusting, nice.
Slimy, yet satisfying.
Just gonna go ahead. This is really pissing me off. So. Popping a little ball back there. Popping a little ball. Yeah, much better. Kick him over. Oh, yeah, okay, so what do you say? I took my daughter to see the Mario movie and she loved it. It was a lot of fun and way better than I could have imagined.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, it just looks, it looks very fun.
Looks like quality entertainment. And that's what we like here. Nice dose of quality entertainment.
Just make my smooth brain happy for 1:30 minute.
1:30.
1 hour minute. And 30 minutes. specifically. Make my smooth brain grow. Smash this in. Look at that, man. The push on the detail looks great.
Thank you, dude. Now it's just got to go everywhere else.
I love that. You're like, man, this is doing great in this one part.
Yeah. Yeah, that eyeball is going to be, that's going to look pretty gnarly in print. That's actually going to look sick now that I look at it. It's going to be nice.
And it's funny, like painting also kind of changes how you sculpt as well.
Oh, yeah.
Seeing it in print, painting it, you start to go, do I really want to go about it this way?
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay, I'm going to save out, take a fiber, check and see if that printer is on fire. Actually, I would just like to see some supports. It's been going for about 4 hours now, so let's see if we can see any resin pop out of there.
I just want some support.
Yeah, I just want to be able to see.
I'll be back. Going to skew out some rocks. There we go. I'm just placing some rocks, some like sharp rocks here. Because the environment needs some sharp rocks. Just to help with the like dynamic angle. Oh, what have we been up to? We are on the road to Monster Palooza. That's it. So we're just prepping. We're just trying to get everything ready so we can meet the people. That's what this is about. It's about saying hello to the people. And having a good time and making some monsters. So hopefully we'll see everybody there. And see some people, see some cool people. That's my goal. Let's see. No 90s Mario Brothers references, but they reference everything else. But not one cyberpunk Dennis Hopper Cooper. Monsterpalooza is the first weekend in June, which I believe is June 2nd to the 4th. 3 day goes Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. If you have not been before, it is a lot of fun. People dress up, they have live makeup demonstrations, lots of art everywhere, and then some good old-fashioned monster people. So it is very rad, very fun. Who else is going? I've only been to comp. You know, they have lots of companies do it. So, you know, and then they have like actors come. I think they have Freddy is coming. I mean, they get lots of actors to show up to sign. Yeah, Guillermo del Toro usually like kind of pops in. I heard Jon Favreau has frequented it. So, I mean, it's a cool event. And lots of 3D prints to buy. People selling art. Again, lots of makeup and mask demonstrations and sculpting demos and chances to kind of meet your favorite monster artists. It's like Comic-Con, but specifically monster focused. So it's just a great time, and I've been going for years, and I've been taking my kid for years. He loves it. We weren't able to go during COVID, but I've taken him before and after that, and he's had a blast every time. I mean, I don't think I'm gonna dress up, because we're gonna be there, and just comfort is king. But I promise you that we will have a fart gun. We will definitely have a fart gun to shoot.
It's a gun that shoots farts. That's all he's been talking
for
about
a long time.
For a long time.
We're gonna have a fart gun. Mason. No, Matt was on his break. Yep, there he is. Like, there's the man.
He's a delicate man.
Welcome back to Party Town. Thank my print just finished.
Your who's a what's it?
Looks good. My mono printed. I just printed another elf head, which was.
Oh, cool.
From all appearances, looks successful. And then I have a pair of pumpkin boys printing right now. My little pumpkin boys. But I'm hoping to have some pumpkin faces, some clay faces, some rugrats. What else? Some bigger buggies, my little bug dudes.
They are coming.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Misty says your beard is fierce, Matt. You have a fierce beard.
Your kind words getting are appreciated.
Growing it out for that monster palooza.
It's gonna be all the way down.
Yeah.
Doesn't it get itchy?
No.
Doesn't bother you.
Not really. I mean, if it was like some giant nuisance, I wouldn't have it, right?
Maybe.
All right. Let's get in there. Let's get in there and get weird.
Get weird with it, baby.
It's morphin' time.
It's morphin' time no more, Rangers.
That's what we like. Shao Kahn laugh.
Zed should have a very Kahn-like voice.
Are you dying over there?
I was slicing with the knife tool. But I think I saved.
The old knife tool.
But I did save, though. I learned my lesson.
That's good. It feels good,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it's like immediately rewarding.
No. Yeah, thank God.
Oh yeah. Okay. Know. Oh, see, I killed it again, but it didn't matter because it was saved.
Wow. Okay.
Morbin, the Morbin Rangers. It's Morbin time. Yeah, that's great, dude. Looks terrifying.
Going to Bangtown.
He's having a bad time.
It's not good, but it's his decision, his body, and his life's work.
I told him not to do it.
Yeah. Good old Bill Birkin.
Guy's having a bad day.
Billy Burke.
Okay, close holes. Boom.
Just that noodle zone.
Yeah, man, we're deep in Noodle Town now.
Yeah, we're in the town of noodles.
Get that boy into Noodle Town.
Oh, that print, by the way, that I just checked on, just a wall of
red. No!
Yeah.
Just a goop.
I'm like, okay. Went ahead and canned it.
You're just, yeah. What can you do? Like, if you love failure, you will love 3D printing.
You will love 3D printing and being an
If
artist.
You love to just... Sadness. Yeah, you will fail and fail a lot.
Thank you.
deep into Noodle Town now.
The depths of these noodles in this town.
Get that man some noodles. What was that? Hi, I'm just wondering if I'm allowed to curse. Is it after 10 o'clock?
Who are we talking about?
Well, someone's asking if they can curse. But, you know, it's after 10 o'clock.
I mean, oh, is so that, I think
so we can say whatever the hell we want.
We can say whatever we want. Yeah, right. Oh, is that it? That's, is that the line? It's after.
So we can say, yeah, I think he's, and he says that we can say whatever the hell we want.
Well, I know he says that, but does he say it's after 10?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, okay.
I'm assuming.
Because it's the adult. It's
yeah,
like
yeah,
adult
this
one.
Is the adult tour. The channel would block it. Oh yeah, don't curse, because the channel would block it. They might block you. I can go in and show the comments. I see. I don't know what any of this means, but we're having a good time.
I
assumed you were making an I think you should. Oh, he means on Twitch and YouTube cursing. I don't know. Like, how bad do you really want to curse? I think he wants to say, like, it's badass, you know? That's good.
That's
what I hope,
hope
he wants. I mean, like, as a nice person. Find the yellow. What do you think, Matt? What material should this slime detail be?
I mean, have you made it like transparent?
It's no, it's skin right now.
Yeah, throw like a liquid on it, you know.
Beer.
Find the right roughness and distance, transparency distance. I think it'd look pretty cool.
I don't think I had fog in there.
Yeah, that's what ended up. What was that?
I said thank you. I said thank you for being my friend.
Thank you for being
thank
my friend.
Thank you for being a friend. Yeah.
Save it up.
Call saving up. Saving up for your first car?
I'm trying to get my first car, man.
Just drive out of this town. This one horse town. It only has one horse.
This one mark.
I've only got one horse.
I'm just kind of grab some of this.
Puppy.
Uh-oh.
In this case, not too bad. I just have to shut down Keyshot. We'll be right back, folks. After these messages.
And we'll be right back. I use this deformation contrast slider.
Yes,
like
so do
time.
I. Like it's, all man, it's so useful. Crammed in Frickles.
Crammed in Frickles. Crammed in J. Findlesworth.
Timbo DeBob.
Timbo DeBob.
Franny Lorvo. Oh, that is gnarly, dude.
Thank you, man. Yeah. Getting into crazy town here.
Yeah, that looks great. I'm going to do something more mutated soon. That's the thing, is like you see somebody working on something, you're like, I want to do that.
Yeah, you're like, I want to
have that kind of fun.
It's a never-ending mutation.
Never-ending mutation.
A relentless mutation, if you will.
It's a bit nutty.
I love that movie.
It's a great movie. I saw that in theaters. Man.
Me too.
We are old.
Feel good. I Okay.
Let's see what it looks like.
Oh, bless you, boy.
Couldn't escape it.
God bless you, son.
Bless you, son. There we go.
Okay. This is the view we'll be working from.
For the rest of the night.
Yeah.
I think I need some gack on the brain.
Ooh, brain gack.
I need some of that stuff. But, like, this stuff's looking cool. I just want to pop it out a little bit more, you know?
Yeah, I feel you.
But, like, the veins are all done. And, like, man, I feel like I'm closing in. I mean, left is, like, I got the helmet.
From oh, yeah. Over.
And then maybe some like smoke or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
You know? Always makes it kind of dynamic and cool.
Dynamic and cool.
You know, you know, powering.
What are those? What are you drawing, dude?
I don't know, man.
What is happening?
I went off on a tangent.
Is it boobs?
No, it's rat pink.
Oh, rat pink.
Yeah, you can see it now. That's yeah. Next week.
Either or, still cool.
It's either or. There's nothing wrong with it. Get some gack on the brain.
You got to start to wonder, is it too late to go to Onage?
Yes, probably too late. Because they need months in advance. Unless you're sending them... I don't know. It might be too late. I don't know.
Something to think about.
Something to think about. Okay. This has some like Enya vibes.
Yeah.
I want to light a candle.
Yeah. Take a bath.
I want to go sailing and light a candle.
I want to go sailing and light a candle.
I want to go sailing out on the ocean.
And light a candle on that ocean.
It's not a critique, James, I promise.
Yeah, I mean, you're our friend. We think you're great.
Trying to put some orange juice on this guy.
Hit him with the juice.
Uh-oh. We lost him. Man down.
Man down? What are you talking about?
I don't know. I heard a blue. I heard a blue.
Oh yeah, that was me saving over my version up. I think it's version 20, I believe. Technically, probably version like 50. I just like to hang out, be friends. Slowly kind of pushing those secondary forms, really trying to make sure that it's going to read like overlapping flesh. Yeah, just like that.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Okay, like two.
You know. Let's go ahead. Pop in a little miniature bonus eyeball. The miniature bonus zone, if you will. You know, just a little bonus. It's the infamous lower back eyeball. God, that was stupid.
What?
Huh?
Huh? The infamous lower back eyeball?
Oh no, I didn't say that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want to put an eyeball on his back, I wouldn't like be mad.
It's already there, man.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
It's like so he can like see you from behind.
Yeah.
And he can look down at his own butt.
He can if he needs to.
Like, he could do it.
Now, we can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way.
Okay.
See, there's that creepy music.
Yeah, that's what we like.
It's like some Mortal Kombat 2, like arena music. They're in like the haunted forest or something. Uh-oh.
Nope, on purpose.
Okay.
I was just doing a little clay pass here.
Dude's doing a little clay pass.
I was just seeing what it looks like in clay. It's like a gray, it's like a matte pass, like a gray pass.
Yeah, man.
That's like a clay pass. Either way, you need to evaluate the forms.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, if you didn't know this was Zed, you'd be like, oh, he's like a meat skeleton warrior.
He's a meat man.
He's like a meat man. With a nice butt.
Dude is got those hams.
Yeah, he's got them hams, man. Look at that butt.
Yeah, it looks great.
Look at that healthy butt. Yeah. You see it in the clay, it looks good.
It's awesome.
Lots left to do, but I feel good.
Yeah, dude, that looks sick.
Yeah, man. Just needs that little bit of extra love at the end.
That would be a gnarly print.
Yeah, dude. I would love to print it on a big printer. Oh, wait.
I have a feeling like my computer is about to explode. It's just a feeling that I have.
Uh-oh. I'm so paranoid now.
All right, let's see that update. Oh boy. There you go. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There's that juice. We're getting there.
Yeah, look at that, dude. Gnarly.
Getting there, man. The eyeball looks crazy, dude.
I love it.
Yeah, that's great. That was a good call on the extra bandage. It's funny how that's, we gave each other the same note.
Yeah, we did, actually.
You should add more veins.
You know, we just have over time, we just develop a shorthand. And that shorthand is more veins. Let's move part.
Rodney Parsons. Good old Rodney Parsons disease.
He's gone full Rodney Parsons. What are my scattering mediums?
Let's go ahead and pop open. Oh God, do not look at my screen. Let's take a meandering gandering.
Totally just killed my Keyshot. It's pretty cool.
Dude, I I hate it when that happens. After, I've noticed though that after like X amount of sending it back and forth, it'll just crash every time.
It gets tired. I think it gets like cranky.
It's the
it gets like temperamental.
It's the temporary memory.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It just kind of overloads
the memory cache. Yeah.
It's just like, I don't want to anymore.
I can't take it anymore. I just wanna die. Exactly.
We are so close to going full ham.
Ham Bellini.
All right, whatever. I don't need it. I have a little bit to fix here. And then, what do you think, Matt? We should wrap this up, yeah?
Yeah, dude. It's time, yeah. Time for me to hit the sack.
Yeah, man. Time flew by tonight.
Got a lot of good work done, though.
I think, if anything, we're just creeping on closer, but we're going to give ourselves something new to do next week because we're in that last kind of like percentage where we really got to go full ham.
It's and a full ham, yeah.
You know, but also we're trying to keep it, you know, interesting for everybody. And sometimes noodling to that last final percentage, I don't know, it can be a little dull.
Yeah.
But dude, holy cow, that looks amazing. That lighting is perfect.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it. Yeah, I'm definitely getting there. Pushing that level of detail is really helping. I want to see his back, actually. Yeah,
good sculpt along content. That's kind of what we hope for, is that like you guys are working on stuff, we're all working on stuff. Kind of reminds you of like being in an office again with your buddies.
Yeah.
And hanging out, making some monsters, talking about silly, stupid things, having a good time. But I feel good about him.
Way digging it.
You know, I just need that last. For me, I feel like if I could put a number on, I would say like he's 85%. What do you think? 85?
Dude,
I gotta finish that.
It looks great in gray, you know?
Yeah. It's there.
Yeah, dude, just finish up that staff and do the damn helmet. It looks awesome.
Staff, helmet, finish the base, and ready to call it.
Ready to Cromwell.
But yeah, man, like this is, I think the pose really made him.
Dude, big time. Really, yeah, it's great.
He really came together and in pose. So why don't we wrap up since it's time. I didn't say the name of our sponsor.
It's time. You got to do it.
It's time. Oh, I'll get in trouble. Okay. Well, hey. Thanks for hanging out with us tonight and sculpting along with us or working along with us, whatever you're doing. You want to shout out to us and say hello, share what you're working on. I'm at MonsterMash042, at Jared Krichevsky. Matt Millard here is at ItchyTasty_. That's a Resident Evil reference.
No.
He's at MattMillard3D. Share what you're working on. Tell us what you're doing.
Yeah.
Come hang out with us. And feel free to visit us on the road to Monster Palooza. Come hang out with us. Anyway, my name is Jared Krichevsky. This has been Matt Millard. This has been the Gnomon School of Visual Effects, the MIT of Visual Effects in Hollywood, California. Creature Corner is sponsored by Lenovo and AMD. Thank you once again. We'll see you next week on Creature Corner.
There, guys. I like that.